excited about today. Get a call to the game on ESPN3, MTSU versus Monmouth. Y'all check us out, 6 p.m. Central Time. Time to go to work.
And I'm a superstar, 'cause all around the world they know who we are. Running behind that money got me missing my bed. Chasing after that paper, I sleep with. Back to back doing shows, I caught a jet to that bag. Just in case.
Welcome to the more behind the scenes of, you know, just my day, man, as a, you know, as I go through as a college football analyst, man. Today, working the MTSU game versus Monmouth on ESPN3. Got to stop and get me something to eat, man. Had to stop and get me something to eat. You know, I got had to go to Subway. Y'all can check it out, Subway right there. I love me some Subway. About to go ahead and get a foot long. And one thing, like, you know, I didn't realize until I started working as an analyst, it's just how much prep time, how early got to be there. Like, the game don't start at 6. We got to be there by 1. So 5 hours of prep for the game, and then calling the game 3 hours. So, you know, I won't get out of that about 9 o'clock tonight. So just got to make sure I eat half of my foot long now. For lunch, and then right before the game, and then that'll probably hold me over to 9 tonight, man. So stay tuned to Mo. Tomorrow, behind the scenes, man, I got more for you.
Back to back doing shows, I caught a jet to that bag. Just in case it get rainy when I check the forecast. I put the money in the flow, 'cause I'm too scared to go back.
All right, just had to, you know, make a stop real quick, man. You know, my wedding anniversary tomorrow, so I had to stop and get wifey a gift. You know, even though I'm working, she's still on my mind, right? Still on my mind, man. I got to make sure that, you know, I do right by her, keep her happy. And, you know, she going to hold it. She holding down the kids like she always do, man. As I gonna be calling this game, she got both of them. You know, they be on 1,000, but definitely blessings, man. You know, I thank God for, you know, these last 6 years, but really, you know what I'm saying, since 2009 when I met Brittany. But, you know, as far as just being married, you know, being married for 6 years, has definitely been a blessing, man, and I can tell and see the growth in us as a married couple. I see the growth in us as parents, and just, you know, how we continue to strive to be better, man. I'll admit, I don't get it right all the time. I do not get it right all the time. But I, by the grace of God, I am growing, I believe, and getting better. Yeah, man, on my way to the game. Now, man, I just made my last stop on the way to the game, man. You know, it's exciting to be headed to the game. You know, I just, you know, it made me think of when I woke up this morning. I even thought about it yesterday, man. My uncle, those that know me, man, Stat Man, my Uncle E, man. Eric Jackson Senior, you know, he passed away a few years ago, and every game day, he used to hit me up and be like text me, hey, game day, JK, and that was, I think that's the last text message that I got in my phone, like, saved. He was like, you know, game day, JK, and I think I was like, yes, sir, something like that. And, you know, that was the last message, you know, that I got from him. So, man, now that I'm on my way to the game right now, I just think about what he said. It's game day. You know, definitely it's game day. Just a different type of game day, right? I'm not on the field, but, you know, to be in the booth, being able to call a game at my alma mater, man, that's all God, man. I thank God for this opportunity. And, man, I don't take it for granted, man. You know, I don't take it for granted at all, man. So, man, like I say, on the way to the game right now, like my uncle say, it's game day, JK, right? But I get to call the game. I don't got to worry about getting hit. I don't got to worry about hitting somebody that's 230 pounds. And then when I played in the arena, but they used to throw them tight end screens. Tight end screens, boy, like 330, 300 out there with the ball. I'm just chopping straight ankles out there. But yeah, man, on the way to the game, you know, I captured more footage. Y'all make sure y'all subscribe to my YouTube page, man. Jeremy Kellem, subscribe to my YouTube page, man. And, man, I make sure I keep up with the behind-the-scenes footage, man.
I think call me, say she saw me on the TV screen. She's proud of me and happy that I'm chasing the dream. Even at your best, never come today. You know, often I get so lost in my thoughts, just thinking about losses. And I remember where I come from, already won. Already won.
Hey, the boy got the VIP parking pass. Let's go. Pull up right to the stadium. Got the AMG where the volleyball play at. Got the Murphy Center over here. Get the mat drills in. I'm assuming I don't want to park in nobody's spot. Just kind of park over here. All right, so getting ready to head up, drop my stuff off. We got a little meeting coming up soon. Production meeting coming up, man. About to get ready to go upstairs, drop my stuff off in the booth. So, you know, just kind of giving you a behind the scenes look of what we got going on today. How y'all doing? Can I, I'm sorry to interrupt. You mind if I go to the fourth floor? Thank you. Y'all having a blessed day?
Yes, sir.
That's good. I am excited about the game today.
Is this the first game?
Yes, ma'am. Yep. Well, I'm actually calling the game. But I play for MTSU, so you know I'm rooting for them, but I can't be biased on TV. So, but definitely, I'm definitely rooting for them though. Do I just press four? All right, thank you.
Four.
Yes, ma'am, four. Thank you. Hey, man, it's crazy how you get treated, man. Just, you know, being on this side, on the other side, you know, as a broadcaster instead of a player, man, you only get to come up here for special moments. So, man, to get this access is dope, man. So, it's exciting. So, here we go. Got my boy Danny on this thing. Hey, my boy Danny used to hold it down. My boy, he eliminated the running backs for me, you know, as a deep middle safety. You ain't trying to tackle somebody that's going, you know, got a whole lane going full speed. So Danny used to do his thing, man. So shout out to all the Carmichaels. How you doing?
Ready for this?
Yes, I am. All right, man, we enter into the press box, man. You feel me? Got the spread. How you doing, man? You know, so that's a 2018 New Orleans Bowl, 2016 Hawaii Bowl, Popeyes Bowl in Bahamas, Armed Forces, 2011. This is my senior year right here, getting to play in that game. Then 2009 New Orleans Bowl, first bowl victory in school history. So it was a blessing to be a part of that team. And this team right here, 06 though, they set the foundation. You know, I believe this coach started them first year, took them to a bowl game. I wanna believe they was co-conference champs of the Sun Belt, man. So that was an amazing start, man. That's kind of my introduction to MTSU, seeing them in the bowl game. You get the view.
from the top. You see, New Orleans Bowl champs. How you doing, man?
Hey, good, how are you?
Doing good. Got my boy Dash. Dash did something that game that nobody had done. I think since Vince Young, BY, in that national championship game. I think he threw for 200, ran for, well, threw for over 200, ran for over 100 in the bowl game, man. So that was dope. Got that boy McCoy balling. My boy Laddie in that day. Laddie said he gonna watch the game tonight. And then once again, you got Danny. And I gotta say, man, this New Orleans Bowl had one of the best trophies, regardless of national championship, Rose Bowl. Like, this New Orleans Bowl trophy goes hard, man. You got the Superdome, where it's Mercedes-Benz Dome now. You know, with the nice ball at the top, kind of remind you of the Super Bowl trophy. These are the conference championships right here. All right, y'all see it? Blue Raiders, TV booth, let's do it. All right, so this is where me and my boy Jake gonna be at. Like I said, I showed y'all earlier, behind the scenes, man. Y'all just see us, but we got a whole bunch of stuff going behind the scenes. All right. So I'm gonna go ahead and get set up, man. And I'll be talking to y'all soon, man. Subscribe to the page too, YouTube page, Jeremy Kellem. We used to run out. We used to run out here. We used to run out the tunnel, dog, with the L's up. Let me turn. Hey, get it turned down a little bit, man. Hey, real talk though, man. Hey, coming out this tunnel, these tunnels used to be a blessing. Never took it for granted, you know. Just, man, soaked in the moment. Came out with the L's, let everybody know from the Dell. Feel me? But yeah. So let's go. We out here, man, on the field. The field looks so different. The field looks so different, man. You look at the stadium. It looks so different, man. But different, you know, is a good thing, you know, when you think about college sports. Because it's supposed to be evolved. Like, the program, when we got the program, the people that left it to us left it better than they found it. And when we passed it off, we left it better than we found it. And so you're supposed to come back and see all of this nice stuff. You know what I'm saying? So, definitely. Let's feel. All right, here. Hardest working man. Boy Larry out here getting equipment right. We out here. Jumbotron, they got the beer guard. They got it looking nice out here, man.
Everybody alongside the safety, Jeremy Kellem. I'm Jake Rose. Sarah Cardona joins us in just a second. And Jeremy, this is going to be a big game for both of these teams with high hopes. Middle Tennessee looking to bounce back after a rough couple of seasons. They've got a new face under center in Bailey Hockman.
Bailey Hockman is used to playing some big-time football. He led NC State last year to a bowl game. He's at the helm for the Blue Raiders this year. So we're going to see if he's able to lead the Blue Raiders to another bowl game appearance.
And one face that's going to be familiar to Blue Raider fans is Reed Blankenship. He is back for his super senior season, and he is leading that dangerous secondary.
Definitely. Reed Blankenship makes his presence felt in the run game. He impacts the passing game, so definitely look out for some big plays from Reed Blankenship tonight. Bari had a great spring season and looking to capitalize this fall. Coach said that he has great contact balance. He's a hard worker, so definitely look out for some great plays tonight from Juwan Fari.
Expecting anytime you go empty, it's going to be a three-step. If you're in the shotgun, it's just really a catch and throw because you don't have any protection. So right there, easy out to pick up a third and short.
It's a wrap for tonight. Man, what a good game. Shout out to MTSU, man. You know, when you call them the game of your college that you play for, you try not to be biased. But you, in the inside, I'm rooting for MTSU, man. I'm happy for Coach Stark. Man, OC Coach Dierman, they look legit out there, man. Different formations, running, you know, running similar plays, but just out of different formations, switching out the personnel. Which I believe is going to work for them when they start going against other opponents in the Conference USA. It's like, now if I'm a D coordinator, if I'm a Virginia Tech, I got to worry about all these different formations that they got to do next week, man. So, man, it was fun. Definitely looking forward to the 30th when I get to call it again, man. So we just going to walk out here to the field, though. They let me out here. Game over. You know what I'm saying? All right, here. Like I said, you know what I'm saying? Just getting an opportunity to call the game today, man. Definitely a blessing. Man, had a lot of fun. Can't wait the next October 30th, so a little month and a half, pretty much, to be able to call the next, Lord willing, man. Y'all see the score? See if I can zoom in out here on the score. You can see it. MTSU 50, Monmouth 15, man. So great showing though. All three phases, great showing. They scored on offense, scored on defense. So, you know, I think just, you know, let me zoom back out though. There we go. Get out of my face. Right. But all in all, man, I think it was a good showing, man. Just solid good showing tonight, all three phases, man. So I appreciate y'all rocking with me. It was behind the scenes of, I guess, a day in the life of Jeremy Kellem, but a day in the life of a football analyst, man. So, you know, I do one every week, you know what I'm saying, that I do them. So the next, you know, the October 30th game and the 2 of November, man. So y'all make sure y'all hit subscribe on my YouTube channel. Jeremy Kellem, and man, check out all the dope content though, man. For real, I appreciate y'all, appreciate the love and support. Make sure y'all continue to wake up, strive to win on purpose, be intentional about winning. Y'all have a blessed day, man. I'm signing out from MTSU. I'ma holla at y'all.